boys all got together at the start of the year, and the guys had been here for a while, pretty sick of losing, you know, and losing in the finals. We've always had winning seasons and that. And then, so when we met, we decided to recruit a couple of key players.
Boys on the block at the Bucks. Former Albany Raiders point guard DJ McGlynn, stellar Perth forward Alan Erickson, and Canadian import and centre Jeff Bevington. They paid their dues in last weekend's 13-point win over arch-rival Bunbury.
DJ played well. He got off to a tough start. I think he had 8 turnovers in the first half and then came good, only 2 in the second half. And then Al's 20 points, I think, might have been top score for the game. So, you know, they've really stepped up. And then Jeff, as his back gets better, it's just improving more and more.
The looks of things so far, I think we got a good chance of winning the whole thing. So if we can come together well as a team and play hard, I think we got a good chance of hopefully getting involved.
But a lot of the players have been here they've been playing for 6 or 7 years all together, you know, so they all know each other really well, and it's great.
Quick, and I'm just happy to be part of the team, still playing well, and we had another good win tonight, so that's good.
I got some skin for you, bro, and some more. Bring it back.
I've been playing with Dan for probably about 10 years now. He's a very, very funny man, very unselfish player as well. I've played with quite a few players in my day, and he's by far the best player I've ever played with.
Spend 5 minutes with Dan Hunt and you'll see why he's been labelled the driving force of the Geraldton Buccaneers.
You're playing for a club you love, you know, and it's easy just to hang in Geraldton and play 300 games. And you've got a lot of great local players here that have kept me going for so long.
Years, nearly 6,000 points, 4,000 rebounds, 1,500 assists and 900 steals. This weekend, he'll become the first in the SBL to play 300 games, all for the one club.
It hasn't been a task. You know, playing 299 games has been a treat. You know, there's never been there's been hard times when we lose grand finals and hard times when we've lost big games. There's been great times when we've had big wins. So those are just numbers that are great. But, I mean, I just love the game. It's been terrific to me, and it's been terrific playing for Gerald.
But it's not just his on-court presence that makes him so special. Insiders say it's his attitude to life and his infectious love of the game.
It's all a high point, you know, as far as basketball goes. It's just going to training's fun now, where it never used to be much of that keen on training. And playing every game's exciting, but geez, you just miss that one grand final win. I wouldn't mind getting that one.
This weekend, when the Bucks play the Mustangs in Geraldton, there'll be a special tribute to Hunt, one of the great ambassadors of basketball and country sport. I have to celebrate you, baby. It's a Bucks are on a roll. 8 successive wins at home, clear leaders on this season's SBL ladder. And after handing a 50-point belting to Rockingham last week, some might wonder what the Bucks are putting in their Weet-Bix.
Everybody's just into it, you know. Everybody's into Bucks basketball right now, and that's the way it should be. There's a lot of stuff behind the scenes too. We've got a great support crew, our directors, our board, you know, and also the crew that helps out around the club. I mean, we're the most spoiled team in the league by a mile.
Eating together before games, drinking together afterwards. Team barbecues on Sundays. These boys are a tight-knit group. Their next big test comes against arch-rivals Bunbury at home next weekend. It was a battle for pride, not points. Both teams made that clear from the outset. The Slammers looking to repay their first round loss. The Bucks out to prove the ghosts of past seasons have been left well behind. A 6-point lead to Geraldton after the first turned into a 6-point deficit at half time. Inconsistent at the net, Geraldton shot just 8 points, Bunbury 20. The Bucks' Greg Brown found it just wasn't his night. 9 misses out of 12 attempts inside the 3-point line. No such problems for Jeff Bevington, the Bucks' most consistent at the backboard with 17. 12 points down at the final change, Geraldton searching for answers. Up steps stellar point guard DJ McGlynn, unrelenting in defence. Still a point down with 2 minutes to go, Geraldton remained defiant as it staged one of its most stunning comebacks of all time.
Such a rivalry with Bunbury, you know, and they've been, what, won 4 of the last 5. They're the most competitive team in the league. They never say die. And for us not to say die when we could have and to come back and win was pretty special.
Tonight we just showed what we can do, you know, and that's looking really good into the finals. I mean, we did it last week against Tigers. We did it this week against Bunbury.
I'd like to let you Geraldton people know that you don't exist. Bunbury is the only people that exist.
It couldn't have come at a worse time. A week from the end of one of their most successful seasons, the Geraldton Buccaneers now face the playoffs without one of their best. DJ McGlynn rushed to hospital Monday night with piercing stomach pains.
I was just at training and everything was going fine, and just on the way back from training, it just got a pain in my stomach, and the pain had like come and go, and then and one time it didn't go away, so I thought I'd better come to hospital.
Despite his absence, the Bucks pulled through their final game against the Wolves, finishing season 2000 on top. But even they concede anything could happen against Kalgoorlie.
One of the two teams that beat us this year, so I think going in, that to me that gives us an edge because we're going to come back a little more focused. And
I still don't know if we're the form side right now, but we're playing hard enough, you know, and getting games, getting it done. But I'd like to find a little bit more form, and I guess you just got to try to play yourself into it, and hopefully we'll do that at the right time.
While they'd come out on top in Kalgoorlie, no one was convinced the Bucks had this one under wraps. Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise, playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday, you got mud on. The final margin, 47 points. The Bucks that big closer to their first SBL premiership.
We're working hard at training at that sort of game, and that's probably one of the best games we've played for quite some time.
You definitely want to wrap it up in two if you can, you know. especially with our team, we've got like 100-year-old players not playing, so they won't be able to get up and move tomorrow, so yeah.
The Bucks were stunning in Saturday night's semi-final. Greg Brown was a man on a mission, scoring 37 points. Fans at Sunday's decider were dumbfounded when Brown didn't score for the entire first half, and Geraldton trailed for three quarters of the game. Buccaneers never say die. Tomo's sharp shooting inspired a 24-10 point blitz in the final term. The Hawks defeated by 9, the Lightning up next.
I knew once we got a close, we were going to beat them.
Pretty confident that we can beat Lakeside. They knocked us off down there, but hopefully we should be getting a bit of revenge.
With little more than 48 hours before Friday night's SBL Grand Final, the Geraldton Buccaneers are in full preparation mode. They're facing league dark horse Lakeside Lightning, rumoured to have a few tricks up their sleeve.
We know that they love to shoot from downtown. They shoot very well from the three-point line. We also know that they're young and they have no conscience. You know, they'll shoot from anywhere on the court.
With the experience and strength of Hunt and Erickson, the flair of Thompson, McGlynn, Bunter and Evans, and Brown and Bevington's power and ability to turn a game, you'd think Friday's final wouldn't be a problem.
Everybody's really excited. It's going to be a good week of practice, and tension's running high, and everybody's really looking forward to the weekend.
They've been here three times before and left empty-handed. More than 500 die-hard fans made the long trek to Perry Lake to watch the Bucks take on the Lightning. Finally, Friday night, the curse on the Geraldton Buccaneers was broken.
On, 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 on. Charge number 21, Ryan.